Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. 1 Corinthians 7:1-6. Now for the matters you wrote about, it is good for a man not to have sexual relations with a woman. But since sexual immorality is occurring, each man should have sexual relations with his own wife, and each woman with her own husband. The husband should fulfill his marital duty to his wife, and likewise the wife to her husband. The wife does not have authority over her own body but yields it to her husband. In the same way, the husband does not have authority over his own body but yields it to his wife. Do not deprive each other except perhaps by mutual consent and for a time, so that you may devote yourselves to prayer. Then come together again so that Satan will not tempt you because of your lack of self-control. I say this as a concession, not as a command. Today's title is Do Not Deprive Each Other. Some people think that Christianity is mainly concerned with unearthly things such as God and heaven. It is true that Christianity are concerned about such invisible things like God and heaven that are somewhat elusive to many people on earth. Although God and heaven are not so visible and tangible for non-Christians, they matter so much to us. People will appreciate the biblical revelation of such invisible things once their spiritual eyes are open. But the Bible or Christianity isn't only concerned with such unearthly things only. It also concerns things that are down-to-earth issues such as business, family, and relationships with other people. Christians do not eschew the real issues of our daily life. It deals with such issues head-on. Today's passage is a good example of it. Apostle Paul takes up a topic that seems to be the most down-to-earth issue of all. He is talking about human sexuality. Now for the matters you wrote about, it is good for a man not to have sexual relations with a woman. But since sexual immorality is occurring, each man should have sexual relations with his own wife, and each woman with her own husband. The issue of human sexuality is considered the most private issue. We do not openly talk about it unless we feel comfortable with each other. Many people are hiding it even though they have some issues with it. But that's not how the Bible deals with it. God knows that human sexuality has a lot to do with human spirituality. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a profound mystery, but I am talking about Christ and the church. However, each one of you also must love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband. Ephesians 5:31-33. Having a right sexual relationship is vital to having a right spiritual relationship with God and other believers. The husband should fulfill his marital duty to his wife, and likewise the wife to her husband. The wife does not have authority over her own body but yields it to her husband. In the same way, the husband does not have authority over his own body but yields it to his wife. Do not deprive each other except perhaps by mutual consent and for a time, so that you may devote yourselves to prayer. When you don't have the right sexual relationship like this, Satan can tempt you. How real and how practical a recommendation this is about human sexuality. It will not only protect and promote the marital relationship but also the spiritual relationship. Are you heeding the godly recommendation for the most earthly and human issue?